Hi guys, myself Neha, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this session of Morning Tales where we will be discussing two very important international reports. So stay tuned till the end of this video and listen to me very carefully. So let's begin this video, and before that I would like you guys to subscribe to this channel and hit this bell notification to get the instant updates. Also, you can join this Telegram group for free quizzes and to get your queries resolved. And also you can ask for guidance on that Telegram channel, and link is in the description box below. So here is the first question. With which country has India signed a memorandum of cooperation for cooperation in the field of information and communication technologies? So this MOC is very recent and it has been signed yesterday only. Not signed yesterday, I mean this was in the news yesterday only. So, India has signed this MOC with Japan in the field of information and communication technologies. Similar MOU has also been signed between India and Japan related to 5G technology. So, this MOU was signed last month, and this month the MOC related to information and communication technologies has been signed by India and Japan. Now guys, about Japan, you would know that recently the PM of Japan has been elected. So who is the recent PM of Japan? That you will be telling me, capital and currency. So these are the three questions related to Japan that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following is the name of the initiative launched by the Indian Railways to provide safety and security to lady passengers traveling by trains for their entire journey from starting to destination station across all the zones? So what is the answer of this question? Can you make a guess? Is it Swadhar Grey, Meri Saheli, Nari Shakti, Mahila Sanrakshan or Suraksha? So out of these five options, it is Meri Saheli. Now you would be amazed to know this thing, that a similar an initiative with the same name, that is Operation Saheli, was launched by Southeastern Railway in the starting of this month. And now Indian Railways has extended that operation with the name Meri Saheli to all zones. So the purpose is clear, that Meri Saheli is to provide security to the lady passengers. And first, on the pilot basis, first of all, it was launched by the Southeastern Railways. So that's all for this question, and now let's move on to the next question. But before that, who is the CEO of Railway Board? Quite an important question it is, because earlier to this year, there was no CEO of Railway Board. There was always a chairman. So now the CEO, that is the new post, has been created in the Railway Board. And who is the CEO? That is your task to tell me. So do tell me in the comment section below. And now let's discuss the third question. So with which country has India signed an MOU for cooperation in the field of health and medicine? So here, till now we have two international agreements, one with Japan and second is this agreement, which is in the field of health and medicine. So do remember the MOUs and international agreements which are signed by India with other organizations or countries. So with which country has India signed this MOU? It is Cambodia. So what would be the area of cooperation? It would be like doing improvement works in the field of HIV, AIDS, TB, COVID. So these are the kinds of diseases and the areas in which Cambodia and India will collaborate to improve each other's condition. So to provide expertise in their respective fields so that the condition in each other, in the other country, can be improved. So that is the purpose. Now, again, the static portion of Cambodia, capital currency and PM. So you have to find this thing. This is your homework for the day. And now let's move on to the next question. What is the name of the messaging app launched by Indian Army for providing secure voice video calling services to its soldiers? So as we know that it is very important to keep the communication of Indian Army or military forces secret and confidential. A new kind of application or a special software is required. So therefore, Indian Army has launched a new application. So what is that? What is the name of that messaging app? So the name is SAI. So what is the full form of SAI? Secure Applications for Internet. So this is the full form of SAI. And do remember the full form as well as the name, because it is very important. Now, who is the chief of Indian Army? Who is the major of Indian Army? That is your question for the day. Now, let's move on to the next question. What is the percentage of GDP that will be derived from digital sector by 2022 according to the Worldwide Information Technology Industry Predictions for 2021 and beyond report? So this is a report. So the name of this report is Worldwide Information Technology Industry Predictions for 2020 and beyond. Now, which organization has released it? It is International Data Corporation, IDC. Now, this report tells us that by the year 2023, the globe, the world is going to transform itself into the digital economy. So the digital, the pace of digitalization is going to triple by the year 2023. And now we have to tell that what is the percentage of GDP that will be derived from the digitalization. So the answer is 65% by the year 2022. Now, in order to achieve this target, in order to get 65% of GDP from the digital sector, the world requires to spend $6.8 trillion. So, if the industries in the world spend this much amount in IT technologies, only then we can expect to derive 65% of our GDP from the digitalization from the digital sector. So that was the major fact of this report. Apart from this, minor fact is that by the end of 2021, 80% of the companies are expected to shift to IT or cloud-based infrastructure. So that's the minor fact, and this is the major fact that this report tells us. So here this report ends, because other facts are not very important from the exam point of view. So I have skipped those facts and told you only the major and most important part of this report. Now here comes the last question, and this is very, very important. So do listen to me very carefully. Global API flows has fallen by -% in the first half of 2020 according to the Global Investment Trends Monitor 2020. Now guys, remember this thing, that this report is released by United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD. Now this report is important for the upcoming SEBI grade examination. There are high chances that a question might come up from this report. Okay, and second fact of importance is that it tells us the data of half year. Only 6 months of 2020 have been covered in this report, and the full year report will be released by the next year, I hope. So therefore, this 6 months report is important for you to remember. Now, the report tells us that in the first half of 2020, due to the impact of COVID, the global FDI flows in various countries has reduced by 49%. So this number is important, and that by 49%, the global FDI flows have been reduced. Now guys, I have a very interesting picture to show you. So let's go to that slide, see that picture and understand the facts of this report. So let's move on to that. So this is that picture which I have taken from the report directly. Here are the various regions. This is the percentage, and these are the actual amount in terms of USD dollar billion. So these are the actual amounts of FDI flows in terms of USD dollar billion. Percentages are there, regions are there, and this dark green portion represents 2020, first half of 2020, and this light green portion represents the first half of 2019. So we have been given a comparison between 2019 to 2020 FDI flows. So now let's have a look at the decreasing trend. So worldwide, the deduction is minus 49%, and actual amount has been reduced from 777 to 399 in terms of USD dollar, USD billions. Then the next important area of focus is developing economies, because India is also one among the developing economies. So developing economies have witnessed the major decrease. It is minus 75%. So it is the major decrease that has been witnessed by developing economies. So FDI flows in developing economies during the first 6 months of 2020 were $98 billion. Then we need to focus on Asia. So Asia witnessed a minus 12 point reduction in its FDI flows, which you can see is the lowest. A good point for us, a good fact for us, that Asia has witnessed the lowest FDI reduction in this first 6 months when the COVID was at its peak. So in the first 6 months of 2019, the FDI flows were $246 billion, and in the first half of 2020, it reduced to $217 billion. So that's all that we should keep in mind from the exam point of view about this report. And here this session ends. I hope that you have really liked this session, and if you have learned anything new, then do subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification to get the latest updates. Thank you so much.